Whoa. Holy shit. Where am I? Oh god, what day is this? November the 29th. Jesus! I don't remember anything in the past, like, 2 weeks. Oh my god. Oh good lord, that must have been one hell of a bender. I went absolutely out of my mind on friggin' pineapple juice. You know, alcoholic pineapple juice. They drink that in Mexico. Yeah, that's right. I was in Mexico. I took a little pre-winter vacation. Went down to Tijuana. Good ol' 2 weeks of debauchery. Drank my weight in pineapple juice and tequila. Gambled. Went to a cockfight. All sorts of illicit prescription drugs. Oh man, that was awesome. Okay, I didn't really go to Tijuana. You wanna know where I've actually been? Alright, I'll tell you. I went to Kuala Lumpur. On secret government business. What kind of government business? Well, if I told you, I'd have to kill ya. In fact, I've said too much already. I will say this though, Kuala Lumpur is lovely this time of year. Nice sandy beaches, palm trees, and coconuts as far as the eye can see. Oh, and the people there are so nice. Of course, I had to brush up on my Kuala Lumpies. But you know, it's basically just English with a few added vowels. Well, once you get used to that, it's pretty easy. Okay, fine. I wasn't in Kuala Lumpur either. I don't even know where Kuala Lumpur is. It could be on Neptune, for all I know. I think it's one of those vaguely European countries. I don't know. Anyway, where I've really been for the past couple weeks, I've been here. I have no excuse for not updating, except that I'm horribly, unimaginably lazy. I'm a terrible person. I deserve to be flogged repeatedly. Oh, I've ruined my career as an LP. As an LPer. All my LP cred is gone. Looks like it's suicide again for me. First time it didn't work out. I came back as a zombie. And then they unzombified me. Yeah, it's crazy what science can do. So yeah, this is the final episode of Let's Play Alex Kidd in the Enchanted Castle. This is the eponymous Enchanted Castle. And it is, like I've said before, the longest, coolest level in the game. Why is it so cool? Well, it's just full of stuff to interact with. There's levers, there's traps, there's doors. In fact, there's a trap right here. If you go too far on the floor, it opens up and you fall. Not to your doom, but it's an inconvenience. Whoa. That room's just full of hazards. But that's why I love this level. It's actually interesting. There are actually elements in this level that usually appear in video games. I'm shocked. It's almost like this is a real game. Okay, maybe that's a little harsh. I mean, I like this game. It's a good game, you know? I mean, most people probably don't agree with me. I know the critics don't agree with me. This game came out for the Virtual Console on the Wii, and if you look at the scores, it's not very good. And you know, I can see where they're coming from. It's actually a pretty disappointing game. I mean, this is Alex Kidd's first foray into 16-bit-dom. And, I mean, the controls are clunky. It's graphically not really that appealing. I mean, it has its charm, but, you know, it's no Sonic, that's for sure. It's probably not even as good as the Alex Kidd games for the Master System. That's what I hear, anyway. I never actually owned a Master System. In fact, I didn't even know the Master System existed until way after the console was dead. I had an NES as a kid. I didn't know it had any competition at all. I thought Nintendo was the only game in town until the 16-bit era. Well, I think I knew about the Atari. And computer games and stuff. But never heard of the Master System until years later, strangely enough. Had a lot more of a following in Europe than in the States, I think. I have a friend in England who had a Sega Master System, and she said that the Alex Kidd game actually came built in. Didn't even need a cartridge. Just turn it on and it played the game. I think that's awesome. I miss the days when video game consoles actually came with a packing game. And you buy an NES and it comes with Mario Brothers. You buy a Genesis and it comes with Sonic. Oh, come on. Go through there. Get in the hole. But no, those days are pretty much long gone. I think the last console that did that was... I don't know. I think maybe the Sega Saturn came with that crappy 3D Sonic game. I'm not sure, though. Did the N64 come with Mario 64, or did you have to buy it? I never had one of those either, so I don't know. Okay, this room's a little... there's a trick to it. You have to push those blocks and make a staircase to go up on the left-hand side. But I choose to take the easy way out. I use the pogo stick. Pogo stick's also a lot easier on this screen, because these blocks disappear when you fall on them. But if you have the pogo stick, then they stay there. I know it doesn't make any sense, but that's the way it is. But like I was saying, yeah, I think the 16-bit era was the last set of consoles that actually included a game when you bought it. Well, there's the Wii, but Wii Sports hardly counts as a game. It's a freaking tech demo. Not that I don't love the Wii, of course. I wish I had one, but... I mean, that's a pretty crappy... free bonus. Well, we could risk it and play Russian Roulette with the spikes. Or we could just take the pansy way out. I could probably have walked through there, but I didn't want to risk scraping my head on the spikes. Okay, this is the rubber room. This is where the mentally ill players go. Whoa! That was very fortunate. Wow, I'm lucky that registered as me hitting it instead of it hitting me. And that green chest looks awfully inviting, but it's just a bunch of bombs. I don't know what the deal with these iguanas is. It's like they wait until the last level in the game to introduce the easiest enemy. All it does is sit there, flicking its tongue ineffectually at you. Uh-oh. Where's the exit? There's no way out of this room, we're trapped! We're stuck forever! Aw, I'm just messing with you. Okay, you wanna be extremely careful when you leave the screen, and I'll show you why in a second. Okay, when you go to the left here, you want to make sure you stay up, because if you are down at the bottom, then you will definitely get hit by that spike. And the only way to know about that is trial and error, unfortunately. It's one of the easiest places to get screwed in this game. It's also easy to get screwed right here. I'll show you why in a second. If you don't know, then you might jump here and make those toy soldiers fall on you through that hole. Luckily, you know, I knew about it, so This level's so cool. Okay, I think one of those chests has a 1-up in it. I forget which one. Okay. And the other one is just bombs, so I'm not gonna... Oops. I wasn't gonna bother opening it, but... Fate had different ideas. And you all saw what I did there. In order to get this item, you just shoot it from across the room. If you try to actually get the chest, then you'll get crushed by the falling ceiling. This is another place you want to have your pogo stick. If you don't have it, then you have to rush under those spikes, and it can kind of be a pain. I hate this next screen. I almost always end up falling into the lava there when I'm not thinking about it.